MTash here, and today we're going to be looking at the Liberty Sidearm. This is a Desert Eagle exotic sidearm with a kick-ass holstered perk, and honestly, some pretty damn good damage if you wanted to actually use this weapon. Now, I don't think I would recommend it in most situations, but you can see, when you actually land your shots, you can pop people for over 100,000 damage. If you land a headshot and a crit, you can hit for like 200,000 damage. And against trash mobs, even in World Tier 4, I'm able to one-tap them with ease. But once they start getting a little tankier, this gets a little bit weaker. Now we're going to be looking at the perks of it, we're going to be talking about how good this gun is, and we're also going to be showing how to get this gun, because as an exotic weapon, I do recommend it, and I think you guys should grind for it, because you might really, really like the holstered perk, even if you're using a different weapon. Sound good? Alright, let's get into it, let's look at the perks. After I one-tap this guy in the body, just... Okay, so with Liberty, you gain 100% damage to hostile electronics or weak points, and while aiming, the weak point is highlighted. Highlighted. That's pretty cool. You can see the weak point, you shoot it, you get bonus damage. Awesome. However, the next perk, Blind Justice, after destroying said weak perk, your next bullet deals 500% damage. 500% weapon damage. That's a lot of freaking damage. You can hit like 400k with this thing. Easy if it's a crit. Now, if that shot kills an enemy, your magazine is then refilled and grants 100% weapon damage for the entire magazine, making this thing hit pretty good. I mean, this thing's got a 44,000 base damage. Now, imagine if you built some pistol damage. Imagine if you crit. Imagine if it's a headshot and a crit. You can hit some pretty crazy numbers, and you get 100% boost to your damage using this thing. So I think that this is going to have, you know, some play. I don't know if it's going to be a top tier weapon, but as a sidearm, it's actually pretty good. But the big one is independence. While holstered, destroying enemy weak points refills 20% of your weapon's current magazine. That means against some of those big beefy enemies with multiple layers of armor, this procs multiple times. If you're using something like an LMG, you can literally keep shooting and never have to reload. I've got some clips of it I'll show you guys in a minute. But this perk alone is a very valuable thing to have, especially if you don't have any other exotics in the game. This is a good one to get early on. So, let's look at it a little bit more in action. So against these big beefy boys, this is going to be one of the best sustained DPS things in the game. Even if you're just shooting as ammo clip, that's a weak point. Even though they're not exploding, anything that breaks off armor-wise is a weak point. It's considered a weak point. And so, breaking off the armor with this LMG, it just keeps refilling the magazine. I've got 25 shots. Up to 30. It's down. Up to 40. It's going down. It's back to 40. It's going down now. It's going all the way down. It's going way down there. Oh my god, another 20. Then back up to 40. Like, guys, when you're breaking armor off these guys, the sustained DPS is gross because you never have to reload. There's no downtime. You can just keep ramping it up, keep shooting, keep being accurate, and melt these big, tanky, bad boys. You can melt these bad boys. It works well with assault rifles. It works well with SMGs. I think that this is an awesome, awesome tool to have. Now, is this going to be absolutely best for DPS? I don't know. Maybe not. Right? You need them to have weak points to really, really take advantage of it. But I think that it does bring some value. And the fact that it's not taking up one of your main weapon slots, that's a pretty good holstered perk to have. I'm really curious. Compared to other exotics in the game, is this going to be one of the best perks? Because it's on the sidearm. It gives it extra value because it's on that sidearm. You don't have to waste a sniper slot, an AR slot, an LMG slot, right? You're just getting rid of a weapon you're probably not using anyways. So I'm a huge, huge fan of this. I'm in love with it, honestly. Now that being said, the only issue is you can only have one exotic weapon equipped at a time. So you can't have the Liberty and something like the Chatterbox. And so when you're looking at that, in the current, you know, meta of the Division 2, Chatterbox is a very freaking good weapon. It is absolutely amazing, because every time you get a kill and reload, you get 20% increased rate of fire. That's a lot of DPS to get. And so you need to make the decision, do you want more utility and reloading, or do you want more damage? Because right now, the Chatterbox probably wins for damage in most situations, other than maybe fighting the big tanky guys. But the good news is getting the Liberty is actually pretty easy. It's a pretty simple process. So let's go over how to get it, let's talk about it, and I wanted to make this video as soon as possible so you don't screw yourself by dismantling one of the key ingredients. Let's get started. While playing through the campaign, you're going to get to the Capitol Hill mission. It's one of the final missions of the game, but you're going to end up fighting on a rooftop and fight one of the named enemies of the True Sons. Now, upon killing this enemy, it's going to drop the pistol trigger and mechanism. This is the first part of the puzzle and will allow you to start this quest line and get the other pieces. Now, here's the issue. After beating this mission, the Black Tusk are going to invade, and they're going to invade all of the different missions, which changes the bosses of said missions, and I'm not sure if you're able to play the originals until you finish these Black Tusk invaded missions. I think there might be a way, but for what I can tell, and because I don't have any footage, I'm pretty sure you have to complete all the missions to essentially reset the map and push the Black Tusk out of these main story missions. Now, because I'm a big dumb idiot, I forgot to record, but you need to do the American History Museum mission next. There's a sniper at the end of the mission that you're gonna kill, and will drop the next part of the Liberty handgun. Or hand cannon, really, because it shoots like a freaking cannon, dude! Afterwards, you're gonna make your way through the Viewpoint Museum. Captain Wade is up top. Captain Wade is, hey! You don't punch me! Captain Wade is gonna spawn after you take out the EMP amplifiers or whatever. So you're gonna have to fight through and get the kill here. Now, be careful, because I had this glitch where I killed him at the same time I was dying. And it actually glitched me under the map on my respawn, and I couldn't complete the mission. I don't know what it was. It was very, very frustrating. So just be careful, play it safe, make sure to kill him, because he's going to drop the next part of the puzzle for the Liberty handgun. It happened to me twice. I killed him, enemies rushed me, I ended up dying, it spawned me underneath, and I couldn't move. It was like a weird freaking glitch. So sit back here, make sure everything's dead, then go over there and pick it up, because I rushed over there, and I got screwed, and it was very, very frustrating, because you have to play the whole mission. This is the very, very end. So after getting the sight and rail, you're going to be heading over to the Space Administration Headquarters. Make your way all the way through this mission to the final boss fight, and this guy, it doesn't matter if you kill him up top, because it'll actually teleport the gear towards you, but if he drops down and you kill him there, it doesn't matter either. I just ended up killing him really, really quick up here, and so the drop came right to me, but I have fought him. You know, down below, he still drops it. You don't gotta burst him down or anything crazy. But he's gonna give you the pistol grip tags as well as Kendra's Liberty blueprint. So both those pieces will drop from him upon killing him. Now comes the most frustrating part, because it's all about RNG. Unless you've already got lucky and have something in your inventory called a D50 Desert Eagle. Now, I highly recommend you share this with your friends as soon as possible, because if they have one and they dismantle it, they're going to be punching themselves in the face, because it's very, very rare. Sidearms are frustrating to get as a whole. You don't get them that much. They're one of the more rare drops as a whole. And not only do you have to get a sidearm, you have to get the D50 Desert Eagle sidearm. And if you don't have that, you can't craft this weapon. There's no way currently to get a blueprint and craft it that I know of, and so right now, unless you get it from a random drop, it's impossible. You have to literally pray that you get this thing to drop. I jumped out of my chair in excitement when I finally got one in the Dark Zone. Now, I don't have any tips or tricks on how to get this optimally, because it is a little bit random. Getting it from a weapon cache could work, a field cache could work. The Dark Zone definitely seems to work, because it seems like you maybe get more military items out of there, but all you need is a D50 to end up crafting this weapon. Another thing that could work, hypothetically, is to do bounties where it will drop a weapon to upgrade your chances of maybe getting a weapon to drop, especially if it says that you will get a pistol or sidearm reward or whatever it would say. I've never seen one myself yet, but that could be a thing to look out for, is if it says that it'll drop a pistol. But farming this is very, very frustrating, and there's no way that I know of other than get as much loot as possible to improve this. So I apologize, but the RNG on this thing is very, very trolly. The final piece is the D50. As for me, I got my D50 from the Dark Zone, so that might be a good option to search for one yourself, but again, RNG, it's bullshit. After you have all the pieces, you go to the crafting station, go into your weapons, and there's going to be a kind of an exotic one here. You've got all the pieces. You need some polycarbonate, some fiber, and then some components. Boom. Craft it. You're done. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. And if you guys could do me a massive, massive favor, make sure to like and subscribe. Make sure to share this video with your friends, and I will see you guys soon. Bye-bye.